What is the difference between data warehouse, data lake, and data lakehouse? Answer of this question, I hope you will find out at the end of this video. Agenda for today is to explain you one by one these three data storages and conceptions how we could store the data when we talk about for reporting, data science, machine learning, business intelligence, and so on. And when you get the idea what they are like a structure, like a conception, then you will figure out what exactly is the difference between them. And in the end, I will give you really nice, I think really nice, but you will see, and yeah, you could share, did you find out like a nice and useful example? The real world example about the difference between them. If you like this video, if you want to be part of our community, don't wait. Click on the subscriber button and not forget to smash bell button too. I will be really thankful about that. Let's start with the actual part. And first, let's start with what is data warehouse? Like a structure, like a way to reach information from our data, that is the first from historical perspective. Before a while, all the businesses should know what exactly happening with them businesses. Usually they work with more than one systems, with some partners and so on, and the whole information that our business have, we should organize it in one place. And when we have it in one place and could get information from our data, then we could get the decisions, could figure out are we in progress, are we in bad position, and so on. And yeah, that is the idea for data warehouse. We get the data from all places, we use the process that it's the ETL process, about it, about the ETL, about EOT processes. And what is the difference between them? You could find out more information about them in my YouTube channel. But here, just to mention like a terminology and like a process in a few words, that is the process that we get the data, transform it, and after that we load it, store it in our data warehouse. And this data is already ready for reporting part. I mean, this is the process that translates the data in information, because actually we have data from 1, 2, 3, it's regarding our business, how many sources could have, how many systems could work, and so on. And after that, when we transform this data in information, we load this information in our data warehouse. This information, our analysts, our business intelligence developers could use, could generate really nice reports, and after that management could get decisions. What about the data lake? Data lake, it's a place where we store the whole data that we have. Here in warehouse, we store only structured data from some files or databases, but the data is structured. Here we could get and organize in one place all the data that we have at the moment, because in 21st century we don't have only structured data. We start to work with video, with images, with audio, and so on, and we could get the benefits from this data. For that reason, it's good to have this data in one single place, which means the conception, like a conception, it's really similar, but because data warehouse working only with structured data, it's not so useful, and so we cannot get the whole benefits of our data if we use it only data warehouse. For this reason, we start with the data lake. We get the whole data, structure, semi-structure, and unstructured data, put in one place. And then when we have the whole data, easy we could generate extra ETL process to organize the data that we want to use for the reporting and put it in the data warehouse. And yes, as you could see here, BI developers, data analysts and so on, financial analysts and so on could use it. Or the people like data scientists, machine learning specialists that want to work with the data, but they don't need to use only structured data. They want to use the whole data. They want to discover the new reports that, for example, until now we don't know that they could be useful for us. For example, that is the work for the data scientists. They need to figure out what exactly we have, what could be the like a maximum value from our data. And machine learning specialists that need the, again, raw data, and they work with the raw data to could prepare good machine learning models, and we to start to predict, to analyze the data, and to have a lot of extensions and positive stuff like different machine learning models that we could use in our business. But data science and machine learning specialists to could do them job really well, they need to work with raw data, with the data that we store in data lake. In data lake we store structure, semi-structure, unstructured, but raw data. That is the raw data. It's not translated. It's just the data. We just organize the data in one single place to could be really easy our machine learning specialist, data scientist to reach it, to find out in one place. And to work with it faster, because it in only one place. Don't need to get one table from one source, from one system, second from another place, files from different file systems and so on, which make them work slower and not so productive, to say. And that's it, the data lake. Raw data, like a first level. After that, what we will do with this raw data, it's up to us. We could organize on second level. Data warehouse, we provide this raw data to data scientists and machine learning specialists, and that's it. About data lake, and like a difference between data lake and lakehouse, here, it's again in data lakehouse we have structured, semi-structured, unstructured data and have the data lake. But here in our data lake we combine in here in this storage, in this place we organize the data lake, the best from the data lake and the best from data warehouse in one single place, because here with this architecture and this approach, yes, in our architecture, like a second level after the data lake, we could have data warehouse, but it's in some other place. I mean, it's in some extra service, to say. And if we want to make it in a good way, usually we put data lake in one storage, in one service, and we need to use data warehouse in second service, which is not so, how to say, not so productive, not so good like performance, because we need to use both of them, data lake and data warehouse, but in one place, easy to could reach the data, to could transform the data and so on, to be really productive. For this reason we start to use, in most of the cases in our work, lakehouse. And yeah, and that's it, like a difference. Here we have only structured data and the specially transform the data from data to information, and actually in warehouse we store the information. In data lake we store the raw data, and after that we could use it for different purposes. And in lakehouse, we combine the best from data warehouse and data lake. If you want to find out more information about these different architectures, I could create separate videos, because actually we could speak a lot about them. And in the end, because don't want to waste of your time and want to give you one real world example to be sure that you understood clear what I mean, let's give you this example. You have fridge. All of you need to eat, and to accept in our example that your fridge is a place that you need to store your data. In our case, it's our food, it's our products, because to could eat, to could get the value from the products and to prepare the dishes and to eat and to get the final information to consume the our products in a good way, as our report in a good way. On the last step, they need to be consumed, but before to be consumed, they need to be put in one place, after that to be transformed, and then to be ready to get some good information from them. And in our example, to accept that our storage, our place that we will store our data, it's exactly our fridge. We need to go to buy products from different shops because we want to eat the best cheese, the best milk, and so on. We put these products in our fridge and we could cook our dishes regarding what we want to eat and prepare in a week. Because usually what most of the people do, we shopping in weekend and after that consume our products in a week. And yeah, and how it's the way how we eat a good food, that it's homemade food. Just don't go to get something from some restaurant. And how we could organize our products, our data in our fridge. There are three different ways to could do that. First way is to go to buy products, to cook and to make a dish from our products. And because our dish will be for more than one portion, we could store it in our fridge. In this example, our fridge store our data, our dish, and we will use our fridge like a data warehouse, because products are already transformed. From the data, we already get the information. We already transform the data in information. And we store this information in data warehouse. In this conception, our fridge is our data warehouse. Second conception. We get the products, but we don't want to cook today. We already have the products in our fridge. We put it there. And when we need to eat and want to cook a dish, just we will get them from it. This conception is data lake. We get the raw data and put it in our fridge, in our data storage. When we will consume and how we will consume, we will decide after that. But we put in our data lake. And the third conception, we buy too many products. We want to eat something at the moment, but want to have enough products for whole work week until next weekend. And then what we could do? Part of the products we could cook and to prepare a dish, and others just to leave in our fridge. In this conception, our fridge will store both of the data. Data that it's already transformed in information, that it's already transformed in dish, and other data that it's just the products that we will cook and could eat directly after that regarding what we want to do. For example, yogurt, we just could open it, eat it without to cook and do some extra stuff on it. That is, for example, for data scientists to say. And yeah, I hope this example to help you to figure out much better the difference between these three architectures, how we could store our data for reporting, for an analytical, and for and for our potential machine learning models, why not? If you like this video, don't wait, click on the like button too. Thank you for the watching, and we'll see you in the next video.